Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and in this video, you'll learn how to use Gmail filters in this short Gmail filter tutorial. So first things first, what is a Gmail filter? Gmail filters are a way of automatically organizing incoming emails. So you're telling Gmail how to filter certain emails based on specific criteria that you set. Got it? Good. So as we go through this video today, keep in mind that I have a ton of videos on Google tips and tricks and Google Drive features and so on. So if you want any more content on the Google ecosystem, be sure to explore the links below. So now that you're familiar with what a Gmail filter is, let's jump in on how to use those Gmail filters. Specifically, we'll focus on how to create Gmail filters, how to edit them, and how to delete them. So there are a couple of ways to create a Gmail filter. One way is to head to your search bar here at the top of your Gmail and select this downward facing arrow on the right-hand side of that search bar. Now there's a lot of different ways to create a filter. So you can filter by email addresses, website, domain names, like for example here, let's just say @finerworks.com, that would be the domain name. So I could filter out anything from that domain. But look further here and notice all of the options we have for creating filters. We can filter to, subject, if the email contains or even doesn't contain certain words. Now you'll notice as soon as you start filling out any of these criteria, the option to create a filter will be enabled right here from this search bar. Now there is another way to create a Gmail filter that you might find easier or a little bit more streamlined, and that's to create a filter right from an email itself. So the email that's already in your inbox. And this is going to be handy if you get things like maybe newsletters from a certain company and you get them all the time to your inbox, but you want to filter them out maybe to a label. You can do that too, right from the email itself. So I've gone ahead here and opened an email directly from my inbox. And right underneath that search bar, I'm going to click the 3-dot menu icon here. And look at this, here is an option to filter messages like these. So we'll go ahead and click that option, and voila, here we are back in that same search functionality we had just gone over with that email address already filled out in the from section. So now you don't have to like start from scratch, it's already done that filter for you. So you can add other criteria here if you want, but if you are satisfied and you just want to filter out emails from that email address, just select that create filter option in the bottom right. Now, obviously the filter isn't fully created yet at this point, because now you have to tell Gmail where you want that email to filter to. So now you'll select from this checklist what you want to happen to emails from that filter you just set. So let's say if you don't want emails coming directly into your inbox, which I imagine you may not in this case, you can go ahead and toggle that option on. And then you can still tell Gmail what you want it to do with the message once it skips your inbox. So for something like this, I recommend applying a label. So we'll toggle this on. Now this is going to help with your organization of any of the messages you filtered. It's really important. After all, you're still gonna want to review these messages and keep things orderly. So if we select that apply the label option, I can now select from labels I've already created here, or I can create a new label. So for this example, I'm gonna create a new label. And remember, this label is for whatever works best for your Gmail organization. So, okay, I will select create for this label I've made. So now I'm back in my options here for this particular filter. And before we finish making this one, I want to point out a very important option here. This is a very handy tip, so listen up. If you find that some important emails are always going to your spam, you can automatically stop that by setting up a filter. So remember all of these options here on what we want to happen to the message that we're filtering. So if you're filtering something that you don't want to go to spam, but it has the tendency to do so, here you go, just select never send it to spam. In which case you can send it to a label or keep it in your inbox if you wanted to, but how cool is that option? So there are a few other options you have when creating a Gmail filter, but here at the bottom, I want to point out another nice feature. Gmail is going to recognize how many other messages you currently have containing this filter criteria, and we can choose to apply this filter automatically to those already existing messages. So not just to the future ones that are coming in, but to these currently in your Gmail. Okay, so I'll toggle that on. So once you have everything set the way you want, just click Create Filter again. So the message I just filtered is no longer here in my primary inbox, but instead, if we look at my labels on the left-hand side here, I'm gonna click on the label I just created, and blammo, there are all the messages I've just filtered. So remember, creating Gmail filters like this can be applied to any email for any reason. So going back to the example of if you have important emails that you don't want to go to spam, what if you have a top client of yours and you want to ensure that you don't miss an email from them ever? Well, you can in fact create a filter to mark certain emails as important automatically without you having to do anything. So let's try that as an example. Let's say this email here is from an important client of mine. We're gonna follow the same steps as last time by selecting the three-dot menu icon, choosing filter messages like these. Now, we'll select Create Filter. And now remember your criteria options. So there are a few ways you could mark emails as important. You probably, first of all, wouldn't want it to skip your inbox, okay? But you could star it. You could ensure it's never sent to spam like we talked about. You could always have it marked as important. Or another thing you can do is add a custom label to it marked important or urgent or classified or whatever it is that's going to alert you to messages from this sender. So to follow this example, I'll create a filter as an example here. Okay, and now we see my criteria have been set here in my inbox because I don't want it to bypass my inbox. This is very important. So I'm gonna go ahead and create the filter. Now you may remember from some of my other videos that you can and should take advantage of color coding in your Google ecosystem. The same can be said here for Gmail. So let's say you've just created that custom label. Why not color code it as well? Something that makes sense to you. It can be by importance, it can be color coded per client or job, whatever makes sense for you. So as an example, I'm back in my inbox here. And we just set that label for these emails that I marked, but I wanna make that label stand out a little bit more with a color, so it's not just gray. So to do that, it's really easy. Just hover over the label you wanna change that's on the left-hand side here, and select the three-dot menu icon that comes up, then select label color, and just select the color you want for the label. There we go, they've all been color-coded. So now what happens if you no longer want a filter you created? Well, you can edit a filter to change your preferences, or you can delete a filter entirely. Really simply, here's how. This time, from your Gmail, go ahead and select the gear icon near the top and select See All Settings. Now from here, click on Filters and Blocked Addresses. And look, here are all the filters that I've applied to incoming mail. And to the right, I can edit or delete any of these filters. So if you wanted to edit criteria for a filter, you'd just select edit, okay? And if you want to delete, you can do so too by selecting delete. So remember, if you want any more Gmail tips, I've got a bunch of links below and again at the end of this video. So that's it for my Gmail filter tutorial. Hopefully you learned how to use Gmail filters properly. And now I want to hear from you guys. What filters do you use and why? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Google content. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time.